Army football. It's more than just a sport and more than just another spectacle for the crowds. It is truly a tradition. Sometimes the multitudes who come to cheer the action on the field unknowingly miss the really dramatic moments associated with the game which occur behind the scenes. One such incident took place on a football Saturday some years ago when a most famous man walked slowly into the Army locker room a few minutes before an important game. His mission at that moment was quite an ordinary one, to give a pep talk to the team. What he said that day, however, was far from ordinary. The team listened closely, for the speaker was quite old and spoke with obvious effort. His voice revealed the burden which years of heavy responsibility had placed upon him. His words were heartfelt and sincere and had a deep effect on those present.
It has been a real pleasure for me to have met personally the members of this season's football squad. Over the years, I have known all of the great athletic figures of West Point's Football Hall of Fame. Since our earliest gridiron victories, the story of their athletic prowess has been the talk and the boast of every campfire gathering, every barracks mess hall, every garrison assemblage of the American Army. In my 20 campaigns covering more than 25 years of foreign service, from the Rhine to the Yalu, from Veracruz to Tokyo, through the muddy sludges of Europe to the blistering jungle trails of Asia, in all that welter of breathless struggle between life and death, always a central topic of discussion and of paramount interest was, will the Army team win this year? The gloom, the dreadful silence that would descend upon our armed men when you failed us was equaled only by the mortal loss of the enemy. The pride, the unrestrained joy at your victories was the very tonic of our own battlefield successes. I repeat the words carved at the entrance to the gymnasium, on the fields of friendly strife are sown the seeds that on other fields and other days will bring forth victory. When the bells pealed out their triumphant tones on Armistice Day, I seemed to hear the echo of the chimes of the cadet chapel. When we ground back into burning Manila to liberate the Philippines, I seemed to see the reflection of the bonfire on the plain welcoming home our winning team. When I received the solemn surrender of Japan to close victoriously the Second World War, through the stuttering words, I seemed to catch the roar of the long corps yell. when we crush the red at Injon. The beat of my mind kept repeating the edict of our forefathers establishing the United States Military Academy at West Point. This great tradition, this great legend, this great ideal is now in your hands. We trust you. We have faith in you. You are our omen of the long gray line. Go out now and win for us.
The words spoken to the Army team that day never went much beyond the walls of the locker room, except in the memories of those who were there. What had started as a simple pep talk had grown into much more. It had become an outpouring of all the love and pride which one man, Douglas MacArthur, held for his alma mater and his beloved Army team. Was a television presentation of the Instructional Technology Center, United States Military Academy.